In 1995, Short Brothers were asked by the Guyana Defense Force to provide some help with an aircraft stuck at Makwak airfield near the Venezuela border. Suffered a heavy landing with damage to the nose wheel mounting structure. The Short's engineers are Jimmy Gibson and Alistair McCartney. Alistair is taking the video. Once they've been dropped off, the Skyvan departs. Once the aircraft has departed, it all goes very quiet out here in the jungle. They do an initial survey of the damaged parts of the aircraft. The Defense Force personnel have removed a lot of the hydraulic components. After the survey is complete, the damaged structure can then be removed.
What do you do? How do you do?
Move that?
Well,
oh, look at the black bar. Why don't you see what you do? See the black.
Damage runs further aft under the floor. The aircraft is securely supported on wooden trestles. Now the structure forward of frame 22 has been removed, and the skins are being removed in order to remove frame 22.
I'm going to air.
Now that most of the damaged structure has been removed, measurements can be made to design the replacement components needed to replace this structure. This information will all be sent back to Short Brothers in Belfast, who will manufacture replacement components. The job will take 4 weeks, so the guys are here for a long stay. In the evenings, the guys have to make up their own entertainment. One morning, the cows were found inspecting the work. Jimmy had to get the picture. Eventually, the Twin Otter arrived with the replacement structural components sent over from Belfast. Also brought all the necessary food and drinks about. After the Twin Otter departs, it all goes quiet again. The new structural components are inspected, and then reassembly can commence. This is frame 22. This is the main structural component. Compressor is fired up, and the guys can start riveting. Jimmy reveals the inner child. It's time for a bath party. Down to the stream at the far end of the runway.
Girls are gonna know that Al was here.
And a rare shot of Alistair.
Say, say something for the girls. Tell them about the temperature of the water.
It's not been warm.
Oh, then the long hike back to the buildings. Most of the structure has now been assembled. The accommodation is what you'd call early colonial. The dining area, the ladies in the kitchen, the radio room, the main hall, now they can start fitting the hydraulic components, the steering actuator, the emergency accumulator on frame 22, and the hydraulic power pack in front of it. Also, the pilot's pedestals are reassembled. Just some final re-skinning to be completed. Morning ablutions for Jimmy. The diamond miners pump water out of the riverbed up to a filter box to wash the gravel and hopefully find the diamonds. They prime the pump pipe from a fire hose, then start the diesel engine. And pump the water up to the filter box. Now we're in the final stages of assembly, with the nose strut fitted. And hundreds of hydraulic components. This is the quiet before the noise of the engine tests. Time to remove all the wooden bracing.
What's it?
We've been coming on
in the nose.
Coming
on
the nose.
A quick look around the bedrooms in the accommodation. This airport is a major postal stop for the region of the country. Some final inspections before the engine startup. The other Skyvan makes a last visit, delivering fuel and other last needed components. We're only a few days away from the finish of the job now. Party continues in the evening. The other Skyvan arrives back for the last time, this time with spare pilots. On this day, the aircraft, repaired aircraft, will get started up and flown home. Last minute preparations for flight. The pilot finds the seat covers. Thank you. it's always good to see a safe takeoff. And Alistair will jump in the other Skyvan to return to Georgetown. Safely back on the ground.